Now the next point of this chapter is the galvanic cell or the whole type cell. Now first we have studied the first type of a electrochemical cell is what? Electrolytic cell. Okay, now the second type is the galvanic cell or the whole type cell. In a previous lecture also I have told that why this cell is called as a galvanic or the whole type cell. It is given the these names are given in the honor of the scientist L. Galvani and A. Volta. So these cell given the name in the honor of scientist L. Galvani and another scientist is A. Volta. So on the honor of these two scientists, this cell is called as a galvanic or voltaic cell. Now basically basic thing happens in this cell. This cell is a spontaneous chemical reaction is occur in the galvanic cell. So in a galvanic cell, electricity is generated through the use of spontaneous chemical reaction in a galvanic cell. So here the electrical energy or electricity is generated, so that is why in this spontaneous reaction, chemical reaction is converted into electrical energy. Now when you are considering the structure or the construction of galvanic cell basically consists of a two half cell. Okay, each half cell consists of a metal and it's a solution, it's a ionic solution with the known concentration. So galvanic cell contains two half cell and each half cell is containing metal screen plus solution of its own iron with known concentration. So this is the basic thing in the galvanic cell. It contains the two half cell and each half cell is made up of a metal strip and the solution of its own iron. Means whatever metal you have taken, the same iron is containing in a solution with a known concentration. So concentration is known. Now these two metal plates are called as a electrode and these electrodes are connected with the each other by the voltmeter for passing the electricity, or you can say the for passing the electrons. These two electrodes are joined together by the electric wire. Then to complete the circuit, these two half cells means the container which containing the electrolytic solution, in that electrolytes are present. So these are two cells are connected with each other, these two containers are connected with each other for completing the electric circuit. It's connected with the one instrument which is called as a salt bridge. So salt bridge is used to connect the two half cells, okay, for making the galvanic cell. So total galvanic cell is containing the two half cell, both are connected with each other by using the salt bridge. Now we'll see what is the meaning of salt bridge. Salt bridge is nothing but it is a U-shaped tube so this like it is a U-tube. In that it is made up of a glass and this U-tube is containing the concentrated solution of KCl or ammonium nitrate plus 5% agar solution. So in a salt bridge, which electrolyte is present? That is KCl. Or in a some salt bridge, there is ammonium nitrate also plus 5% agar solution. while making the salt bridge, what they are doing in a U-tube, in a glass U-tube, KCl or any inert electrolyte is taken. That inert electrolyte with the agar solution, it is a hot solution that will poured in a U-tube and it is cooled for some time, and then this tube is kept inverted in a container. Okay, so this tube is placed in any container for making the electric current. This U-tube is placed in a container. When it is used, it is placed in a electrolyte to making the two cells connected. But when it is not in a use, it is placed in a distilled water. Okay, so salt bridge is basically a U-tube, glass U-tube, in which inert electrolyte is present like a KCl or ammonium nitrate with the 5% agar solution. When the salt bridge is not in a use, it is placed in a distilled water, and this opening of this U-tube is containing the glass wool. Okay, when we are using the inert electrolyte for the salt bridge, this inert electrolyte does not react with the any electrode solution, or it does not oxidize or reduce at a any electrode. Means when you are taking the or you are making the galvanic cell, in that you are using the salt bridge. But whatever solution present in a salt bridge, means like a KCl or ammonium nitrate, it is inert. It does not take part in any cell reaction, or it does not react with the any electrode solution, or it does not reduce or oxidize at any electrode. So this is the salt bridge. Now what is the function of salt bridge? Salt bridge provides the electric contact between the two solutions. Means for a galvanic cell, there are two half cells. So when these two half cells are connected by salt bridge, what is that function? It provides the electric contact between these two solutions. Second one, it prevents the mixing of that two solution. Means we are taking the two half cells, each half cell containing a solution and it's a electrode. So that two solution does not mix by using the salt bridge. And third one function is, it maintains the electrical neutrality by passing the ions of this electrolyte solution. Okay, so it maintains the electric neutrality. So this is about the galvanic cell. So basically galvanic cell madhe kya hota ki spontaneous reaction karte. Spontaneous reaction means the chemical reaction is converted into, or you can say the chemical energy is converted into electrical energy. And galvanic cell is containing the two half cell. Each half cell is made up of a metal strip and the solution of its own ion with the known concentration. म्हणजे जो मेटल तुम्ही घेतलेला आहे त्याचं सोल्युशन काय असतं, की त्याच्याच आयनचं सोल्युशन त्या कंटेनर मध्ये असतं विथ द नोन कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन. फॉर मेकिंग द गॅल्वॉनिक सेल, दिस टू हाफ सेल्स आर कनेक्टेड युझिंग द सॉल्ट ब्रिज. सॉल्ट ब्रिज इज नथिंग बट द ग्लास शेप, यू शेप्ड ग्लास ट्यूब इन विच इनर्ट इलेक्ट्रोड लाईक अ केसियन और अमोनियम नायट्रेट यूज विथ द 5% अगार सोल्युशन. When it is not in a use, it is placed in a distilled water. Okay, so this is all about the galvanic cell. Now the next point we'll see is the formulation or the short notation of the galvanic cell. Galvanic cell is represented with some notations, short notation, or we can say the cell formula. When you are representing the galvanic cell, we can write it down the short notation for that cell. Now this short notation includes mainly the electrons. Another one thing it includes, that is the solution of, you can say the aqueous solution of ions. And third thing is that the spaces which may or may not be participate in a reaction. In the cell reaction. Okay. So see, when you are writing the formula for a galvanic cell, or you can write it down the short notation for a galvanic cell, it includes the electrodes, aqueous solution of ions, and third thing is the spaces which may or may not be take part in a cell reaction. Means these three basic things are there when you are writing the formula for the galvanic cell. Now we will see the steps, or step wise we will see how we can write it down the cell formula for the any galvanic cell. Means suppose you have taken the, or you have given the electrodes. Another one basic thing in a galvanic cell is that here anode is a negative electrode and cathode is a positive electrode. ओके अपोजिट टू द इलेक्ट्रोलिटिक सेल. इलेक्ट्रोलिटिक सेल मध्ये कसं असतं की एनोड हा पॉझिटिव आहे आणि कॅथोड हा निगेटिव्ह आहे. बट इन अ गॅल्वॅनिक सेल एनोड इज अ निगेटिव्ह इलेक्ट्रोड अँड कॅथोड इज अ पॉझिटिव्ह इलेक्ट्रोड. सो व्हेन यू आर रायटिंग द फॉर्म्युला फॉर द गॅल्वॅनिक सेल, फर्स्ट स्टेप इज दॅट वी हॅव टू राईट द इलेक्ट्रोड नोटेशन फॉर द इलेक्ट्रोड्स ऍट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेल फॉर्म्युला. मीन्स व्हेन यू आर रायटिंग द फॉर्म्युला ऍट दॅट electrodes are written at the end. So in a notation I will write here, electrodes are written at the end of the cell formula. Okay, now here anode which is at the left side, negative electrode, and this is a positive electrode. So anode represent, or anode will be written at the extreme left of the cell formula, and the cathode, that electrode is written at the extreme right of the cell formula. Okay, हे दोन इलेक्ट्रोड पहिले काय करायचे, इलेक्ट्रोड साठी नोटेशन लिहिताना पॉझिटिव्ह इलेक्ट्रोड आणि निगेटिव्ह इलेक्ट्रोड ऍट एक्स्ट्रीम एंड ऑफ द सेल फॉर्म्युला लिहायचे. जो तुम्ही सेल फॉर्म्युला लिहिणार आहात त्याच्या दोन्ही एंडला काय येणार आहे, इलेक्ट्रोड येणार आहे. मग निगेटिव्ह इलेक्ट्रोड मीन्स द एनोड, इट विल कम इन अ लेफ्ट साइड ऑफ द सेल फॉर्म्युला. आणि पॉझिटिव्ह इलेक्ट्रोड विच इज कॅथोड, which is at the right of the formula. Now the second thing is the aqueous solution of ions, that we have to represent. Now these, where we have to write, now for the notation of aqueous solution of ions, that we have to write after, that means the at the interior of cell formula, after or the adjacent of this electrode. Means when you are writing electrode, I will write here this electrode. After that we have to write the aqueous solution of ions. Okay, त्याच्यानंतर काय येणार आहे, aqueous solution of ions. हे झालं फर्स्ट इलेक्ट्रोड साठी, म्हणजे एनोड साठी. सिमिलरली हियर वी हॅव टू राईट aqueous solution of ions, and now we are electrode. हा इलेक्ट्रोड कोणता असणार आहे, आता कॅथोड. पण एक्झाम्पल घेणारच आहोत तर तुम्हाला समजेल. मी इथं फक्त वर्डिंग मध्ये लिहित आहे, इथं इलेक्ट्रोड कोणता येणार आहे, हा निगेटिव्ह इलेक्ट्रोड. जे फर्स्ट स्टेप मध्ये आपण बघितलं की इलेक्ट्रोड रिप्रेझेंट करताना काय करायचं, सेल फॉर्म्युलाच्या ऍट द एंड, एक्स्ट्रीम एंडला दोन्ही घ्यायचे आहेत, एक निगेटिव्ह इलेक्ट्रोड येईल, एक पॉझिटिव्ह. आफ्टर दॅट तुम्हाला काय घ्यायचं आहे, एक्वियस सोल्युशन ऑफ आयन्स, म्हणजे जो एनोड घेतलेला आहे निगेटिव्ह इलेक्ट्रोड, त्याच्याच आयन्सचं काय असणार आहे, एक्वियस सोल्युशन. इथं सिमिलरली तसंच की इलेक्ट्रोड तुम्ही पॉझिटिव्ह इलेक्ट्रोड घेतलाय, तर जो इलेक्ट्रोड घेतलाय त्याच्याच आयन्सचं काय असणार आहे, ऍक्वियस सोल्युशन. हे फक्त शॉर्ट नोटेशन काय करायचं, रिप्रेझेंट करायचं, मी इथं वर्डिंग मध्ये लिहिलेलं. नाउ द थर्ड स्टेप इज, नाउ व्हॉट एव्हर रिमेन्स इन द स्पेसिस विच मे ऑर मे नॉट रिप्रेझेंट पार्टिसिपेट इन द सेल रिएक्शन, दॅट विल बी रिटन इन द मिडल ऑफ दिस पार्ट. म्हणजे जो सेल आहे आपला, सेल फॉर्म्युला जो आहे, त्याच्या मिडलला आता काय करायचे, ज्या स्पेसिस दॅट विल बी reacted or not reacted in a cell reaction, that will be written in a middle part of this cell formula. And finally, concentration and pressures for a gases. Okay, solution saturated concentration and the pressure for the gases, that will be written with the aqueous solution. Whatever concentration and the pressure for a gases is given, that will be written in a cell formula. Then, okay, so this is all about for writing down the or for the formulation of this cell. Now, the next point is that for formulation of cell, in that the vertical line, this vertical line represents the phase boundary. Okay, so this represents the phase boundary. Now see here, when we are writing the electrode, okay, that electrode is in a solid state. So it's a phase, and we have taken here aqueous solution of ions, its a phase will be different. Sometimes some gases are there, so the phase of electrode and that electrode solution is different. So that phase is divided or separated by using the vertical line, which is called as a phase boundary. So here, when you are writing the cell formula, I will show here that electrode and aqueous solution is separated with the vertical line. Here also we have to write the vertical line to represent the phase separation. Okay, so that is the next step, and last one is salt bridge. So two vertical lines represent the use of salt bridge. Now salt bridge, as it is galvanic cell, it containing the two half cells. That two half cells are connected with each other by using the salt bridge. That salt bridge is denoted with the two vertical lines. So here we have to write the two vertical lines to represent the salt bridge, and then only the writing down of your that cell formula is complete. Now see here, when you are writing the cell formula, okay, cell formula आपल्याला represent करायचा आहे. समजा तुम्हाला एखादी cell दिलेली आहे galvanic cell, and the question is like that, write it down the cell formula for the given cell. Okay, so how we can write it down? First we have to write the electrodes at the extreme end of cell formula. Okay, then next point is what? It's a whatever electrode you have taken, it's a ions aqueous solution, that we have to write adjacent to the electrode. नंतर आपल्याला काय करायचं आहे, इलेक्ट्रोडच्याच ऍडजसंट त्याच्या ऍक्विअस सोल्युशन ऑफ आयन्स ते त्याचं नोटेशन रिप्रेझेंट करायचे. द नेक्स्ट वन इज अ व्हॉट एव्हर कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन इज गिवन फॉर द सोल्युशन ऑर द प्रेशर फॉर द गॅसेस, जे काही नोटेशन दिलेले असतील ते तुम्हाला तिथे रिप्रेझेंट करायचे. नेक्स्ट वन, व्हर्टिकल लाईन्स रिप्रेझेंट द फेज बाउंड्री, मीन्स द इलेक्ट्रोड अँड इलेक्ट्रोड सोल्युशन इज सेपरेटेड विथ द व्हर्टिकल लाईन, इट रिप्रेझेंट द फेज बाउंड्री. अँड लास्ट वन इज अ टू व्हर्टिकल लाईन्स in between the two half cell represents the salt bridge. We'll take one example, then you can understand how to write the cell formula. Okay, suppose you have given the two electrodes, one is anode, another one is cathode. Suppose you have given magnesium is a anode and silver Ag is a cathode. Okay, and then question is what? Write it down the cell formula for these two electrodes. Okay, or write it down the cell formula for the galvanic cell in which magnesium is anode and silver is a cathode. Asa jar question asel, so how we can write it down the cell formula? First see here, first thing what I have told, that we have to write the electrode at the extreme end. Now here मॅग्नेशियम इज एनोड, एनोड आहे मीन्स निगेटिव्ह इलेक्ट्रॉन विच कम इन अ लेफ्ट हँड साइड ऑफ द सेल, अँड ए जी विच इज कॅथोड विच वी हॅव टू राईट ॲट द राईट ऑफ द सेल फॉर्म्युला. सो आय विल राईट हियर मॅग्नेशियम विच इज इन अ सॉलिड स्टेट अँड ए जी इट इज ऑल्सो इन अ सॉलिड स्टेट. सो आय हॅव रिटन हियर दिस इज वॉट दिस विल बी, हा काय येईल एनोड असेल आणि हा कॅथोड. द नेक्स्ट वन पॉइंट दॅट वी हॅव टू राईट, इट्स अ इलेक्ट्रोड सोल्युशन किंवा ॲक्विअस सोल्युशन ऑफ द आयन. सो एम जीचा आयन काय येईल मग, एम जी टू प्लस. ओके, सपोज वी हॅव टेकन हिअर वन मोलार सोल्युशन ऑफ दॅट एम जी टू प्लस अँड ए जी, दॅट विल बी एम जी सॉरी ए जी प्लस. सपोज इट्स अ कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन इज ऑल्सो वन मोलार, Ag plus 1 molar. Okay, and now this cell is separated, or you can say it is connected with the salt bridge. Now see here, इन दिस वे यू कैन राइट इट डाउन द सेल फॉर्मुला. बघा क्वेश्चन मध्ये जर तुम्हाला या पद्धतीने दिला असेल की मॅग्नेशियम इज एनोड, सिल्वर इज अ कॅथोड, राइट इट डाउन द सेल फॉर्मुला फॉर द गिवन गॅल्वॅनिक सेल. नाउ इन दैट दिस टू इलेक्ट्रोड्स रिप्रेजेंट्स द दिस सी Mg is an anode, Ag is a cathode, that is why we are written here at the extreme end. Then next one is a, we have to write the aqueous solutions, okay, adjacent to the electrode. Aqueous solution dile with concentration, yache concentration dile mhanun concentration ani bracket madhe lihilele aahe. Then ata he je he aahet te aqueous solution astat, in that also you can write it down, it's a condition, aqueous solution aahe mhanun condition ni tumhi lihu shakta. Now the next one is what, vertical lines separated the phase boundary, okay, vertical lines represents the phase boundary. Here aqueous solution ahe, this is solid, here also solid aqueous, so that will be separated with this vertical line. And next one, last one is the two vertical line represent the salt base. So in this way we can formulate the cell, okay, or you can say the, you can write it down the short notation for the galvanic cell. So I hope you understood this, how we can write it down the cell formula for a given cell. Now the next point we have to study is the writing up of cell reaction. Now how we can write it down the cell reaction. Suppose you have given the cell, any galvanic cell, then the question is like that, write it down the cell reaction for the given galvanic cell, okay. Or sometimes this galvanic cell is given in the form of cell formula, cell formula cha form madhe dileli aste, kiwa directly the question is asked like, write it down the cell reaction for the given galvanic cell, ya paddhatine question vicharla jato. Now how we can write it down the cell reaction for the given cell. In that, first basic thing or the basic assumption we have to think is that cell reaction corresponding to the cell notation is written on the assumption that the right electrode, right side electrode is a cathode and left hand side electrode is a anode, okay. So basic assumption madhe, basic assumption when you are writing the cell reaction is that what, at right hand side the electrode is a cathode and on the left hand side the electrode is a anode, okay. Now when you are considering these two electrode as a anode and cathode, in the previous part of this chapter we have studied that the anode, that electrode, why it is called anode, because the electrode kiwa anode anode kadhi mhanaycha kiwa anode mhanje kay, so the electrode at which the oxidation takes place is the anode, and cathode is what, the electrode at which reduction takes place is the cathode, okay. So in this reaction kiwa in this cell, only different thing is that anode is a negative electrode but oxidation takes place at the anode, cathode is a positive electrode but reduction will takes place at a cathode, okay. Basic thing is rahnar hai, फक्त इथं जे साइन आहे, एनोड इज अ निगेटिव्ह इलेक्ट्रोड आहे, कॅथोड इज अ पॉझिटिव्ह इलेक्ट्रोड आहे, बट एनोड वरती ऑक्सिडेशन होईल आणि कॅथोड वरती काय होईल, रिडक्शन होईल. सो कन्सिडरिंग दिस रिएक्शन वी हॅव टू राईट द हाफ सेल रिएक्शन, ओके, बिकॉज द ऑक्सिडेशन इज अ मीन्स वेन यू आर कन्सिडरिंग द सेल इन दॅट एनोड वरती ऑक्सिडेशन होतंय, मीन्स दिस ऑक्सिडेशन हाफ रिएक्शन, ऑन कॅथोड देर इज अ रिडक्शन रिएक्शन, सो देर इज अ half reduction reaction. Now when you are writing the cell reaction, in that first step is what, see here, write the oxidation half reaction and reduction half reaction, okay. So using that cell formula kiwa je cell tumhala dileli ahe tyachyavar varun kay karaycha ahe, you have to write first oxidation half reaction and the reduction half reaction. Okay, so that is the first thing we have to write when you are writing the cell reaction. First one you have to write oxidation half reaction and reduction half reaction. Second one is we have to write the net cell reaction. Net cell reaction. How we can write down the net cell reaction? By adding the both half cells, we get the net cell reaction, or you can say the overall cell reaction. Now while writing the net cell reaction, the number of electrons, whatever number of electrons used in that cell reaction, we have to cancel that electron. Now for cancelling the electrons in a both reaction should be same. Okay, the electrons cancel करायच्यात आपल्याला दोन्ही रिएक्शन मध्ये. ज्यावेळेला तुम्ही नेट सेल रिएक्शन लिहिता तर त्याच्यामधले नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स कॅन्सल करायचे, मग हे कॅन्सल करायचे आहे तर ते नंबर जो आहे नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स शुड बी सेम. इफ नॉट सेम देन वी हॅव टू मल्टीप्लाइड विथ द हाफ रिएक्शन टू द हाफ रिएक्शन बाय न्यूमरिकल फॅक्टर टू मेकिंग द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इक्वल. हे नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स सेम नसतील तर काय करावं लागेल, एखादा न्यूमरिकल फॅक्टर घेऊन त्यानं त्या सेल रिएक्शनला, एका सेल रिएक्शनला किंवा दोन्ही सेल रिएक्शनला तुम्हाला काय करावं लागेल, मल्टीप्लाय करायला लागेल टू मेक द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इक्वल, अँड देन ओनली यू कॅन कॅन्सल द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. ओके, सो वेन यू आर, वन थिंग यू शुड रिमेंबर इज दॅट वेन यू आर रायटिंग द नेट सेल रिएक्शन द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन विल बी कॅन्सल, अँड फॉर कॅन्सलिंग द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स द ऑल नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स शुड बी इक्वल. ओके, नाउ विल राईट वन सेल फॉर रायटिंग द सेल रिएक्शन. ओके, आय विल राईट हियर सेल. Here, nickel solid आहे, Ni2+ with concentration 1 molar, aluminium 3+ with concentration 1 molar, aluminium in the solid state. Now see here, how we can write it down the cell reaction for this. See here, nickel is written on the left hand side of this cell formula, means here nickel is a anode, and here aluminium is written at the right hand side of this cell formula, means aluminium is a cathode. Now at anode which reaction takes place? Oxidation. At cathode, reduction. So first what we have to write? Half oxidation reaction. I will write here half oxidation reaction. दोन किंवा तीन स्टेप मध्ये आपल्याला सेल रिएक्शन लिहायची आहे, त्याच्यामध्ये पहिल्यांदा काय करायचं, हाफ ऑक्सिडेशन रिएक्शन लिहायचंय. आता हाफ ऑक्सिडेशन रिएक्शन लिहिताना इथं इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्लो जो आहे तो कोणत्या डायरेक्शन मध्ये होईल बघा, मीन्स निकेल इज अ एनोड, सो एनोड वरती ऑक्सिडेशन होईल, मीन्स व्हॉट, देअर इज अ लुझिंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन, अँड अल्युमिनियम इज अ कॅथोड, मीन्स देअर इज अ रिडक्शन, मीन्स गेनिंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन, मीन्स इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्लो फ्रॉम निकेल टू aluminium, this side. Okay, so electron flow is on this direction. Okay, from nickel to aluminium, in this way the electrons will flow in this cell. Okay, so half oxidation mare nickel cha kay honare oxidation. How we can write down the reaction? It will lose the electrons, mean nickel solid will give Ni2+ with the losing the 2 electrons. Okay, as it is Ni2+, means it will lose 2 electrons. Now second one, what we have to write? Half reduction reaction. Reduction, so aluminium is reduced, so how we can write it down that? Al3+ will gain the 3 electrons for conversion of aluminium in a solid state. See here, it is Al3+, means it will require 3 electrons to convert into 1 mole of aluminium. Okay, now these two cell reactions we have to write from this net cell reaction. Now see here, I have told that when we are writing the net cell reaction, what we have to do? We have to combine these two reactions, half oxidation and half reduction. But when we are combining this, we have to cancel electrons. Okay, now here 2 electrons are there, here 3 electrons are there, means number of electrons are not same, so we have to find our numerical factor to multiply these two reactions for making the number of electrons equal. Now which factor we have to multiply? See here, we have to multiply here with the 3 and here for a 2 to make clear. Now bagata ita 3 na multiply kela, so it will become 6 electron. 2 na multiply kela 6 electron, means number of electrons become equal. Now with that, ata ita fakta ma electron la multiply nahi karayche. We have to multiply whole cell reaction. Okay, so after multiplying 3, what you will get? 3ni converted into 3ni 2 plus plus 6 electron, and here what you will get? 2Al 3 plus plus 6 electron will convert into 3 mole of aluminum. And then finally you can write it down, the net cell reaction, by cancelling out this number of electrons you will get 3ni plus 2Al 3 plus 3ni 2 plus plus 3 aluminum in a solid state. So this is the final net cell reaction. So in this way you can write it down, the cell reaction. Okay, so the final cell reaction ahe. Nickel will convert it into Ni2 plus, aluminium 3 plus will convert into aluminium solid. So in this way you can write it down, the cell reaction. Okay, we will stop here.